Welcome to the Twickenham Stoop for Allianz Premiership Women's Rugby. It's cold, but not as cold as it has been in West London. And certainly a good performance today would warm the souls of any Quins fans. It's been a patchy season so far, and the visitors today could claim the same. Two women signed with pedigree and class, both looking for a foothold in this season's campaign. It is Harlequins who take on Loughborough Lightning in round 7 of PWR. Let's have a look at today's fixtures and the table. We can have a look at what's coming up. Leicester versus Bristol has already kicked off. That's your game. Second on the list, Quins versus Loughborough. We'll be looking at that. And then first versus second at the moment, kicking off at 2:30. And then rounding it all off, Trailfinders versus Gloucester Hartbury at 4:45. A packed afternoon of Allianz Premiership Women's Rugby. Let's have a look at the table as it stands. Those three teams at the top have put a little bit of light between themselves and the others. Our two teams are part of that melee in the middle of the table. Next two fixtures for Quins, if they win them today and then next week against Bristol, could see them make a push towards those top spots. It's a good crowd as amassed here in West London. And there's good spirits around for us all with a bit of a boogie. A few moments ago, we caught up for a word with Harlequins head coach Amy Turner to get her thoughts on this fixture.
Well, Amy, thank you for joining us. A big game always at the Stoop. But what's been the chat this week ahead of this game? What have you been talking to the squad?
I think we were really pleased with coming away from Leicester with a win. A win away from home is massive, especially with the competition of the league. And we were really pleased at parts of what we did and achieved, and it was just growing on those positives. Recognising Loughborough are going to come into this game truly believing that they can compete, and it's going to be a competitive game. So what are we going to do about our game to level up? And focus a lot on mindset. So as a whole, we're in a really positive place, and we know we've got to start well.
You used a phrase there which brilliantly sums up Quins at the moment, pleased in parts. How do you close the gap? How do you make sure that it is an 80-minute performance from Quins?
Look, we're going to get mistakes because we're an ambitious side and our DNA is to play and entertain, but we have to get the nuts and bolts of our performance right to enable us to do that consistently. So breakdown is massive, set piece is massive, defensively we've got to be organised and we've got to have the ambition to win the ball back. So those are the nuts and bolts to enable us to play.
How difficult a knot are Loughborough going to be to untie?
They're going to be physical and fit. They pride themselves on their collisions and their play width to width, looking for opportunity. They've got good players in the middle in Helen Nelson and Helena Rowland. They've got some big ball carriers, so they're going to be competitive.
Good. And where's the Quins magic? What's the 10 minutes looking like for you? What are you really keen to see in the opening shots? What do you want?
Intensity and urgency of work rate, like the stuff that takes no talent. We've got an incredible amount of talent. We want to see everyone for the 80 minutes doing the stuff that takes no talent, the grunt work. And if we can do that, we'll play how we want to play.
Good luck today.
Thank you.
Some good answers there from Amy Tucker, Turner. She's growing into this role particularly well, and I think there's an exciting opportunity this afternoon to take on a very good Loughborough Lightning side and make a little bit of a statement. A quick look at the teams, both coaches making minimal changes to the sides that took the field last time out. Indeed, Quins' only change is a late one. Sarah Bonnet fails a late fitness test and therefore Kiara Cooney is promoted to the six shirt. Lucy Packer at scrum half does make the starting lineup, having suffered herself with a late battle with illness against Leicester. The Loughborough Lightning side, they welcome back former Quin Chloe Rawley at 15, and a shift around elsewhere in the back line sees Matt Aitoga move to 13, and Helena Rowland switched to fly half to replace the injured Helen Nelson. Lightning's pack also has a late change. Abby Duguid is promoted from the bench after the influential Catherine O'Donnell withdraws late with injury. Sally Williams comes to the bench. A big loss that for the Lightning. And joining me alongside me, late, but I'm so glad you're here. A lot of duty out there, I know, a lot of signing, a lot of smiling and photos with kids. I'm absolutely delighted to have Jade Conkle. Jade Conkle, welcome. Should be a good game this, shouldn't it?
Yes, I am very, very excited. You know, biased, there's a lot of Scots out there today, which will be great. But no, super, super glad to be back at home. The crowd is absolutely buzzing, which is incredible. And hopefully we're going to have a really good flow of rugby.
Yeah, let's get into a bit of detail. That loss, late loss, Loughborough Lightning, Catherine O'Donnell missing. That's going to be crucial. And I think that will just give a little bit of extra pep in the step to the Harlequins team. They'll like that, won't they?
Yeah, Cath O'Donnell is an immense player, really physical. She brings a lot of experience being an England cap. I think, you know, that's a really good for us, obviously, but yeah, obviously hope to see her back out there soon, but something that we can hopefully then target is up front.
Let's talk about narratives and storylines that have come out of this season. Where are Quins at the moment? You're the club captain, you should know the answer to this, although it might be a difficult one. Where are Quins and where do they need to be?
I think we're building. We've got a lot of new faces this season. You know, it's been a bumpy start to the season, but the way you build strong teams is through fighting through adversity. It's about learning how to be resilient. And, you know, we've had a couple of really strong seasons where we've made the semi-final and it's kind of not really been a question, whereas now the whole league is improving, which is exactly what we want. And we've got to adapt to that and we've got to build, but we've got to take each game as it comes and learn from each of the games, and that's only going to help us improve throughout the season.
We saw the table a little bit earlier. There's this squash in the middle of teams who are perhaps a little bit patchy in form, can be brilliant, but can also let in tries. Loughborough and Quins fit into that sort of bracket, if you like. But Quins, the next two games I mentioned, this game and then Bristol, win both of those, it's the league starts to look a bit different for Quins, doesn't it?
Yeah, definitely. And I think that's the beauty of what the table looks like at the moment, is you cannot say who's going to make top four. Could be anyone ultimately, and you've got to perform for that. And I think that's the importance of not thinking too far ahead, but actually focusing on the job at hand and focusing on the now. Like, if you do your job, then the outcome's going to take care of itself.
A little word on Freya Orkin, who makes her 50th appearance today as the teams make their way out. It's never easy to play any game of rugby. 50 games of rugby is pretty special.
It's absolutely unreal. And I remember when Freya first turned up, she was one of our newbies, and just the way she's improved is absolutely incredible. She's one of the, you know, spikiest like players that you got. I just think she brings such a great thing to our team, both at nine and wing, and she's such a versatile player and a great human. So really, really happy and pleased that she's getting her 50th cap today, because she deserves it.
And here they come. I'll let the crowd do the noise. Little moment in the spotlight for Freya Orkin there, occupying the wing spot this afternoon, but equally adept at scrum half, and could be a very useful cog this afternoon in the Harlequins wheel. A few photos and things.
It's just so great seeing so many mascots there. Like, I was signing some stuff for them earlier and they're just so excited to be here, and I love that we're able to put on a show for the crowd. Makes such a good difference to us on the pitch, as having so many great supporters.
I know sport is about winning, it's about performing, but also it's about that, isn't it? It's about the little people. It's about inspiring people.
Yeah, we're all people at the end of the day. So you want to make sure that people know that we're just other people, and we want to strive to get people to see that they can do it too. So it's great to see.
Our referee, Hamish Grant, on the touch judge, Daryl Chapman and Simon Adams. Ellie Kildan has the ball in her hands and the countdown is happening. Ball is looped high and good chase there, puts pressure on Lightning. Great opening 10 seconds there for Harlequins, put a stamp on things. Into the midfield they come. Packer starting, disappointed last week. Lucy Packer to opt out late on. Tweema looking to test the brackets and braces of the Loughborough Lightning defensive line. Again goes digging. Scott unleashes a back line. Burford off the left hand. Kildan, a little wild, and Over the top it goes. They'll come back for the penalty. Opening passage of play for any game of rugby, really important. You want to get those hits in hard. You want to get those bits of skill done super specially well.
Seen a big carry there in the midfield from Caitlin Leaney, who was just awarded Australian's Player of the Year. Absolutely fantastic to see her out there making a stamp in the Premiership.
Caitlin Leaney, one of a few Australians making a home for themselves in West London. I meant that from a rugby point of view. Obviously, West London's full of Australians of all sorts. But from a rugby point of view, there's just a smattering of Antipodean accent around the place. Always good. Good line out as well from Harlequins, who build well. The back of that is Connie Powell, who has the ball under her wing. And looking for the eyes above the counter, just trying to find her way through it. Lightning repulse slightly. And Packer will dig down and get hold of it. Burford, half a dummy, doesn't really want. Came back inside. Packer again, looking for weapons to assemble themselves outside it. Packer comes back this side. There's a little bit of a mismatch and a bit of space on the left hand side. The call came in a little late. Here comes Scott now off her right hand. Brings in the aforementioned Leaney. Good carry. That's the 22 metre line. Pack again, another ball player. Tweema, Scott, Kildan. Tried to step away from trouble, couldn't quite free herself. Cleo with a nice little offload to her front row partner, Tarani. The Italian making a lot of friends in this part of the world. And oh, what a gap that is! Huge, great big back for Harlequins to storm through. And guess who? The poster girl herself, Shauna Brown. You don't give invitations like that to Shauna Brown and not expect her to capitalise.
I think that was brilliant from Quinns overall. We worked edge to edge. You could see that we were patient. We wanted to create some gaps, and then a great spot from Shauna Brown. She loves a pick through the ruck, and that's exactly that right there. Shows just how dangerous she can be when she does it.
Yeah, let's have a look at just exactly how it was created. Oh, the guards with their eyes elsewhere. And Shauna Brown firmly with the present beneath her grasp and saying, yeah, I'll have that all day long.
You know, when you're covering that and you've got Shauna Brown running at you at that pace, you do not want to be on the other end of that. So great crack and run from Shauna there.
Another try to Shauna Brown's growing tally. And the kick from Tweema is good, as it has been so many times this season. Tweema, the England international, 72.7% return, and very high up the charts. Only Gloucester's kicker in front of her at the moment. Emma Singh doing slightly better, but Harlequins will be very happy to have given Tweema such an easy opportunity and a big stamp of approval on proceedings. They will want to capitalise on this start and not give Loughborough any sort of way back into this.
This is very much where we need some composure and to exit and get back in the halfway mark.
Kildan looking for that touchline, really nice gather from Rolly, who will have something to say to her former teammates this afternoon, no doubt. Always an extra little bit of buzz when you come up against players that you used to play with. Back across the back line, Loughborough go, looking out left and trying to get a little bit of a passage of play going themselves. Neat little ball inside from Abby Duga, the late replacement and addition to this Loughborough Lightning side. And behind it goes, and Matai Toga just took her eyes off the ball. Matai Toga moved from fullback to centre. I wonder whether just to steal and cause problems to this fantastic centre partnership that Harlequins have, Tweema and Burford. Matai Toga and Morel, they'll have a case to make this afternoon. Should be an interesting matchup that in the centres.
Yeah, definitely. And you see the way Loughborough like to play. They like to work edge to edge. They like to get the ball out the back. They like to move the balls and the point of contacts with the carriers. So that's something we need to be aware of. And like you say, their centre partnerships, pretty deadly, so you want to make sure that you're shutting those down, so you're not giving them space on the outside, because that's where they're really going to thrive.
Crouch.
First look at the scrum. Fight. Captain Wells, Catherine Treader, Christine Belisle.
Set.
In the front row for Lightning, up against Tarani Powell and Cleal. The scrum doesn't get as far as a put in. Referee will have a little chat with all six of them. Hamish Grant scrutinising exactly where they are and what's going on. Scrum time, especially early scrums, an opportunity for any prop forward just to try and create a narrative in the referee's mind.
Set!
Packer does put the ball in and eventually it makes its way to the hindmost foot. Scott has her hand out and teeters forward. Still Dunn and Burford looking for a little bit of space. The bend from Burford. Burford carries the ball well. Packer, Scott again. Bit of space on the left-hand side. The offload from Fleming, a little ambitious. Still Dunn has to go and get her dustpan and brush out and sweep up. Just inside their own half, Harlequins. Packer takes her time, comes left again with the call. Tarani, neat little offload, looking for one more. Yes, it does come. Brown, the early try scorer for Harlequins. His conduit, the ball continues.
Aaron back into the half.
Scott, crossfield kick is going to put a bit of pressure on the back three. It's a good take from Westcombe Evans, who doesn't need any invitation to come forward. Three tries to her name so far this campaign, and the referee's seen that.
She goes 10.
An infringement, okay, a quick tap, and away Harlequins go. A little bit of an insight into how they want to play this afternoon. Brown on to Tuima. Ellie Kildan didn't know the ball was coming to her, but eventually gets there. Kildan, a little flick of the hips, and away she goes. Wilcott, good carry from her, good presentation from her. Scott has to come in because there's no scrum half. Packer delayed at that last breakdown. Now Packer comes in and goes short side. Fleming, Kildan, handles the initial tackle quite well.
Tackle!
Then hits the floor. Clear, says the referee. Again, good line. Fantastic stuff from Lochner. Lochner needs support. Down to the floor she hits. Good passage of play from Quinn's here, keeping their wits about them. Right they go. Scott again. Tuima, the ball looks as though it's crept forward. Referee's going to agree with me, but Jade, good passage of play.
Very good passage of play. I think every single game Danielle Lochner's played so far, she's made a break like that. Unreal. You can see how athletic she is from a netball background. Incredible to see her getting a lot of game time here and really thriving in rugby, because she's not been playing for that long. So it's been great to see her out on the pitch.
I was going to ask about that, because Lochner had appeared to me as someone who was learning the game, had come to it quite late. I mean, physicality is huge. I mean, you're big and you're strong, that's great, but the techniques of the game need to be employed quite quickly. How difficult is it to learn as a sport? I know that's something, probably a question dar for you, I should be asking her, but from your point of view, reading how she's dealing with it, is it something you can get?
Yeah, it's difficult, but when you've got a player like Danelle who wants to learn, she puts everything into it. She makes sure she does what needs to be done. She'll learn, she'll watch it, she'll work in every aspect that she needs to work at, which is what makes her the great player that she is, and she's only going to get better.
Yeah, indeed. So much of the game also reading the patterns in front of you, reading the space, and she did that exceptionally well to find that gap in the ground.
You could see in the last scrum in the centre of the pitch, the loose head went down a bit early, so it's going to be some words said, and hopefully we're going to have a stable scrum throughout the game.
Let's start building now then.
Referee, didactic tone.
Bind. Set.
Ball is in, and then off the back. The big runner of Morrell, 19 years old, the inside centre for Loughborough Lightning. Huge potential. And Ekil Dunn scampers over and grabs that as it makes touch. So it will be a Harlequins ball. Yeah, real opportunity for Carmela Morrell, 19 years old, up against the likes of Burford and Tweema.
Okay, you stay there. Just
the
open up,
sort of thing you dream of as a young player. I know it sounds almost people
just
who don't
open up.
Understand rugby, but young
mark.
Players love to go up against their heroes, don't they? Okay, I mean, that's what it's all about. Great. Test yourself.
Yeah, they definitely do. And, you know, I've been around a long time now. And I remember when I first joined, I was playing against the people that, you know, I thought were superheroes. So it's absolutely incredible to see younger players coming through and playing at such a high level.
Packers ball off there is a little scrappy. Scott and Tweema just about sorted out between them.
Second advantage.
Packer, inside ball, almost
okay,
pretty good.
Really nice line, just little basics letting us down there, but the line itself, great line to play, good identification of space.
Okay. Yeah, really good from Freya Ocken and just that
number
pass.
Four, just
maybe
early.
The call came a little
wait
late, I'm not sure.
Lineup,
we'll go back for the number penalty four. Anyway, Harlequins will be pleased and Langi Tweema will get a chance to poke this down the right-hand touchline.
I think it's evident already, Loughborough here to play. They're putting on a really good shift so far and, you know, they're really making Quinns work for every little inch that they're getting.
Yeah. Also, at some point, maybe now isn't the right time, but two massive players in Loughborough Lightning sort of recent past, Emily Scarrett and Sarah.
If they come down, just wait.
We're
going to
talk
please.
About how a team sort of moves on from losing players like that, but maybe we'll have a look at this line out first. But it is a point, isn't it? Big players that bring legacy. There's an element of trying to work out how to follow it. How do you follow a player like Sarah Hunter?
You know, I think they've left the legacy, so you know they would have taught the girls as they went through. Oh. And you know Emily Scarrett's still around, and I hope she's back from injury soon. But yeah, incredible to see those players, you know, leaving such a legacy in the game.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I didn't want to retire Emily Scarrett that early, but you're right. But she's not here in the moment, and I hope you realise what my question meant there.
Yes, of course.
Quinn still building, testing the edges here of the Loughborough Lightning. Ruck.
Use!
Bryony Cleo puts her head down and burrows her way forward. Lightning doing well just at the moment to hold fast. Now the ball is loose and Lightning are going to get a little opportunity here to break it. Good work from Cabella, I think, just to tidy this one up. And Lightning will get a chance to clear their lines. Malcolm in there, as per usual, trying to firm things up.
Okay, advantage over.
Roland's right boot does clear the lines, and Lightning will be happy with that. That was a test, and they came away with it.
That was brilliant defence there from Lightning. You could see the partnership working. There's one low, one high, and they're really stopping our players dead on the spot. You could see the difference that makes when you're, you know, freeing up the ball, and that's exactly what they did. They got the ball back.
Loughborough Lightning made more tackles than any other team up to this point in Allianz Premiership women's rugby. And at the moment, it seems to be working quite well. They'll have some more work to do as Quinns come down with the ball on the 22 from the line-out. Shauna Brown again, the try scorer, trying to cause some issue. Packer has to dig this one out. Cleo, a little
tackle!
Run up from her. Again, the hits just keep coming from Harlequins. People rolled into position. The latest is Fleming. Packer goes back the other way. Cleo's little pop pass. Again, Lightning having to be good. Scott Burford, almost against the tide, comes back inside. Packer and Brown again. Tackles and back row especially making heavy work of it at the moment. Left it goes, that's better. More alacrity from Harlequins allows them to get up and inside. Left again, Scott choosing. Burford, lovely try. Really nice, Tweema in the corner, but all made by the patience and the build-up. I'm just going to have a little chat, make sure.
Okay.
Yeah, the referee agrees. Really good score by Tweema in the corner, but such a passage of play building up to it, Jade.
Let's make it
It was just a full team effort there. Like, you could see it's not necessarily about the line breaks, it's about working inch for inch. And you've seen the forwards doing their job there. They were getting the carries dominant, they were landing on ball, we were getting the clearers over. It was winning us those inches, then create space on the outside, which then the backs pulled the trigger when they needed to. And it was great play from them, great distribution from Rachel Burford there.
And crucially, Scott has options both sides, which keeps the inside honest and allows the space outside.
Absolutely, and if she doesn't have space, she'll find space somewhere, and that's, you know, the caliber of player that Emily Scott is. She'll create so many opportunities, but there, you know, she had options, which helped her out a lot, and we managed to score in the corner.
Really neat score from Harlequins. Langie Tweema has a pretty tricky kick, but this is very much in her wheelhouse. Just can't bring it round and give it enough. Just slightly got underneath it a little bit. I gave her the big lead up. That's always that happens when a commentator says that you're good at kicking. Sorry, Langie. It's just part of the course. It's what happens. You say something good about someone and they don't do the job.
So we're blaming you for that one, right?
Yeah, just don't tell her. Here we go, though. Lightning back with the ball in their hands. And there was a passage of play there where Lightning will have been happy with their work. And they'll have the build again here. Roland's right boot picks out green pasture, and a little bit of miscommunication there allows the ball to bounce. Wilcock, time to work back.
I think that was a lovely kick from Helena Rowland. She placed it so well. They're the hardest kicks to receive because they're not high, they're not low, they're just in between, and it's really hard to see where it's going to land and get your timing right. So miscommunication, but also just a very, very good kick from the 10.
Connie Powell, the England international, is going to throw into this line-out. Saw her firing them into Steve Halsey's big yellow hoop a little bit earlier in the practice. Packer finds Kildun. And Kildun finds the touchline neatly, although that was brought back in. Again, more miscommunication. Hands on knees from Ellie Kildun, and a sharp intake of breath. Hand goes up. A little bit of mistake there.
Yeah, we're going to have to learn from these small mistakes, because ultimately there's 80 minutes in a game, and, you know, she'll be kicking herself at that. But ultimately we need to be better in that decision making and, you know, look where we are, and actually also help Ellie out by comms in on the pitch, like talk to her as she's going.
Lightning come down with the ball. Nice little line from Morel, helped by the ball from Cabella. Penalty though. An immediate respite for Quinns. Burford tiptoes forward as if to take control of the situation, as is her wont.
Here we just need to focus, kick to the corner, set up outside our 22, but no, we tap and go. So you're saying we do the opposite of what the commentators say.
Jay Conkle.
But it worked out brilliantly.
Finding it exactly as it is. Ellie Kildun, though, what about the bounce? Oh, it bounces over everyone. There we go.
Well, I'll eat my words for that, because we've ended up in their 22, so...
What do we know from up here? Absolutely nothing. Quinns are going to build from the 22 and in the inside ball. Although Loughborough have made their way back and again find themselves at the hand pump, working hard. Good line from Powell. Tweema. Kildun, little step and go. Wilcott will bend her way in field. Packer, Torani. Oh, that'll work. Packer now with quick ball. Shauna Brown with runners. One of them is Cleal. Cleal almost with the offload. Yes, it does go. Yes, it will work. Harlequins are in again. Shauna Brown with a brace. But again, it's not just the way that they play. It's the amount of consistency with the way that they do it.
Absolutely. You could see that we wanted to play with speed there. So again, we were getting the ball away nice and quickly. And really, really good work to get your hands free from Bryony Cleal there. She managed to get that offload away to give Shauna that space. So the hard yards and the whole forward pack there was just ultimately incredible. But getting up to that point, you know, hats off to, you know, taking that chance to run that. And look what's happened. We've come away with a try.
Do you ever feel as club captain that they don't listen to you?
You know, they're usually a pretty good bunch, but, you know, it's easier from up here to go for the safe option. But what I think with Quinns you get is you get that entertaining, you know, play, and we want to play, we want to move the ball, we want to play exciting rugby. And you know, that was exciting rugby. Wow. So it's great.
100%. Langi Twemo is going to add the extra points, and she does. She obliges this time. But yeah, it's the sort of rugby that sells tickets. It's the sort of rugby that gets people on their feet. And they do like it here in West London.
Any form of break, you can hear the crowd absolutely roar, which is so good.
Now once again, Lightning back with a restart. And it's going to start to wear, this process.
You see Jenny Maxwell running water for Loughborough, who's recently come back from a very long, lengthy knee injury. So it's great to see her back, and hopefully you'll see her back in a Loughborough shirt soon as well.
Here, here. Chloe Rowley is going to try and take the ball back with a little bit of interest. Matai Toga. Ball is pumped into the midfield. Kabea, England international, in the back row. Good run from Abby Dwigid, the late addition to things here. On the knock on there, just again, as I was about to sing her praises, the knock on allows Quinns back the ball. And it's those little moments at the moment, Jade Conkle, that seem to be going the way of the quarters.
Yeah, definitely. Again, I think composure's playing a lot into this, especially in defence. We haven't had to defend too much yet, but it just shows that we've got to stick to our processes there, because like we said before, Lightning are a really good attacking side and they're going to stretch us. So, you know, trying to slow them down is going to really, really help our defensive line.
A little stat for you that both these sides are very good at not conceding turnovers, also very good at not winning turnovers. So theoretically, both these teams should be able to hang on to the ball. But at the moment, Lightning seem to be coughing it up. And
set.
Quinns,
stay up here, stay
from
up.
A position in which you think an exit might be on.
Never say
might
never.
Might be different. Scott has Kildun behind her. I didn't see that sort of kick being employed. Rolly, lovely feat from the former Harlequins fullback. Good run from the Scotland international. Lightning want to see more of that from her.
It's one thing you don't want to give Rowley is space.
Get in behind Quinns. Westcombe Evans on the left hand side. Good carry again from her. A little tip on there. And again, Treader playing her role, tumbling through the gap. Again, an inside pass.
Tackle!
Rowland doing well to manipulate defences at the moment. Good over the ball, slight opportunity there. Oh no, says the referee.
You can see Loughborough's been targeting that inside pass, and perhaps that's an indicator that we need to stay a bit higher on the inside. And they're looking for those gaps around that kind of initial collision. So I think we need to have a real focus of staying high on that inside, so they're not going to get much go forward with that inside pass.
Roland's kick to the touchline is a good one, and into the 22. Loughborough Lightning tiptoe. Interesting to see how Quinns are able to deal with this. As you say, maybe an insight Lightning looking those tip-on passes, that change of direction. Maybe something that they've spotted, Nathan Smith and his team. Bit of an opportunity. Rolling maul is formed. The African violet jersey swarm around the ball. Then the secondary push makes a little bit of an indent. Davey is looking for it and gets a face full of Harlequin's defender for her trouble as well. Davey just checking her nose to make sure it's still in place. Good carry from Kabea. Powerful leg drive from the number seven. Free hit this one. Referee's got his arm out in favour of the visitors. Now Davey, crossfield kick is going to hang really neatly. Lovely catch, lovely score. Very nice from Loughborough Lightning. They had the advantage. The dice was rolled by Rowland. And a neat score from Georgina Tasker.
That was a great play from Loughborough there. You could see after the maul, Harlequins have worked really, really hard to move them sideways. They've had to use it. Then perhaps our fold was a bit too slow coming out of that. And we know Loughborough are a team that want to play wide. So we needed to get that fold a bit quicker, because the blind side, there wasn't really much to defend, whereas we still had probably too many numbers on the blind. And they've spotted that, spotted where the space is, and scored in the corner. Exactly what they're good at doing.
Yeah, difficult take as well, that from Tasker, running onto the ball and also having to keep her mind on where those defenders were. She managed to catch it and dab it down neatly. And she leaves Rowland with a conversion from out wide on the right-hand side.
Yeah, based on the scoreboard, you know, it's in Harlequin's favour, but Loughborough aren't going to take this lying down. They've come right back at us, and that's exactly what they're going to look to do again.
Rowland with one in off the post. She'll smile to herself. She runs back there. And, well, if you're an unconnected visitor to this game, that is exactly what this game needed. A good Loughborough Lightning try, which just resets things a little. And Harlequins will have to just make sure that they don't get too ahead of themselves with this game. Ellie Kildun's kick is an awkward one to watch bounce. And Morrell will come forward with it. Ball in the hand as well. Neat work from Wassell. Tip on pass from Malcolm, the captain. There goes Mate Toga. Kabea is calling for it, the try scorer. Tasker, good offload from her. This is better from Loughborough Lightning, who seem to have had a huge fillip of confidence from that last bit of play. Rowland whips the ball out, the American treader. Good carry from her. She made another couple of extra yards when perhaps she shouldn't have done. Rowland again, starting to just control things a little. Harry again from Wassell.
Tackle!
Good work, Quinn.
Quinn's respond to the referee's request. Ball out wide to Tasker. Forward, says the referee. A little nod from Jade Conkle, who agrees with him. But I just sense that things have slightly changed with the Lightning there. They just look as though they've got a bit of self-belief about themselves now.
Yeah, definitely. And you can see Helena Rowland really taking charge of that. She had a, you know, rough bout of injuries last season, but she's come back in great form like she always is. And, you know, she's really stepping up and dictating the flow of the game. Unfortunately, Helen Nelson's not playing today, who's another, you know, 10 partnership that she works really well with. But Helena Rowland's stepping up and making sure that all the decisions and the ball and the distribution is right where they need it to be. And that was a really good pass to play from Loughborough.
And much like Quinn's had the flow of the ball, suddenly Lightning just having phases and going through them, just getting that going, getting the machine working time after time. Does improve the mindset. Amy Turner talking about mindset before the game. What were the things being said in camp, Jade, as regards mindset this week for Quinn?
I think it's like, you know, don't be afraid to just get dug in. Like, you're going to have to find that dark place. It's going to be a really tough 80 minutes against Loughborough because we know they're going to chuck everything at it. So it's making sure that you are being dominant in those collisions, and ultimately that takes mindset. You need to know that it might hurt a little bit, but you know, you're going to do what you can to make sure that's as dominant as you can make it.
Bind.
Sticking your heads in dark places, some may say.
Set!
Okay, you first.
I would if I could.
Penalty there at scrum time will make the Quinn's players smile a little. It's a much easier position in which to advance up the field. And Langi Tuimo's going to poke this one with her right boot down the field towards that 22-metre line. It won't quite get there.
I'm just going to try and not say anything when we've got like the ball to play with, because are they going to kick, are they going to tap? I'm not quite sure, but it makes it exciting.
I did think that you were biting your lip there, but no, that's fine. Maybe you should, JKR, maybe you should say more, maybe you should make it, be really negative and see what happens to the game.
Commentator's curse.
Well, make it work for you. Tuima, Shauna Brown, fending off the player and then trying the offload. Quinns have gone backwards slightly, but now make a little bit of extra yardage.
Such a strong carry there from Beth Wilcox on the wing.
Doing a good job for a slighter lady. Good carry from Tarani as well. She's a wonderful character. Before the game, she only had one thing on her mind, and that was cheesecake. The Italian making a lot of friends down here in West London. Good carry again from Fleming. Two tries to her name in this campaign so far. Again, More good work from Leaney. Brown. 22 metre line and an extra roll it is that the referee has seen, and it penalises and allows Lightning off the hook somewhat.
Yeah, you can see that we're looking to move the ball, but sometimes when we're looking for those offloads, our body shape changes and then we're not going square, which means when we land, the ball's really exposed. So then you've got to fight to try and hide the ball. But that's, I guess, when you're square, you land on ball, it makes it easier. But unfortunately there, we've just been caught on our back, tried to protect it, but then ultimately, yeah, get a penalty against us.
Kick hasn't gone into touch. Ellie Kildun comes forward with it, with an air of expectation around the crowd. Anytime the wonderful fullback gets her hands on the ball. Packer and Scott. Fleming gets hit hard. Good carry from Powell as well. Close quarter combat at the moment. Wide. Burford. Two players in her face. She will be well marshalled, no doubt, this afternoon. Never too far away from a Burford offload. Scott again, juggled with by Powell, but she does just that. Scott, little delay for Kildun. Kildun also delays the pass. Maybe a good option because it brings other players in. Cleal, offload off the floor, is clever. Packer thinks about going herself. Huge tackle from Cabella on her opposite number. Gap there from Burford, lovely offloading. Powell. Riding shotgun. Scott out wide it is, and the referee's seen a knock on. Tiny Cleo has her hands out as if to suggest what's gone on, but the referee's seen it. But once again, the offloading game, just being able to open up Lightning.
Yeah,
dangerous.
Brilliant attacking play there from Quinns again, looking to move the ball, but it's coming from the dominant carry to begin with to create the spaces elsewhere, but then actually the confidence to move the ball within that. But hats off Loughborough there, their scramble defence actually made that difficult, and ultimately there they've ended up with the ball back. So, you know, the scramble defence is working, but we are managing to just break them down little by little. So hopefully in the game that keeps continuing, but like I said, Loughborough are a class side that they can shut us down as well.
Talk to me a little bit about Sylvia Turani. She's an absolute character, and earlier I mentioned it, you know, she was screaming for cheesecake a little bit earlier. I don't know what that's about and how that works, but she seems to be bouncing around the place at the moment.
She's absolutely brilliant. She's been a great asset to the team this season. I think it's so great to see her play, and she's just one of the nicest humans. Like, she makes sure everyone's included. She does, she always brings in some baking, some random blocks of cheese as well, but it's the baking that, you know, really gets people's attention. But, you know, she goes out of her way to make sure everyone feels included, says hello, and she just brightens up your day, which is great.
Great to hear the former Chiefs player, Italian international. And you need your characters in the front row. It is a dark place. You need the light.
I've been there. I can confirm it is. Never going back.
A bit of a tension here, I think.
Okay.
Lightning front row just needing a bit of extra help here.
Just a quick one. I know Sarah Bonner will be watching from home, who unfortunately is not able to play today. She'll be absolutely buzzing seeing the scoreboard for that and seeing the go forward. And it would have been a great game that she would have thrived in, but we hope to see her back next week.
You don't miss a trick, do you, Jade? Very good.
They're just all my friends.
I was looking forward to seeing Bonner in action, but I'm sure she'll be back.
We've got a replacement running in.
And I think there's a replacement's going to take place for Quinns here. And I'm not sure if it's a head knock and whether it'll be a 10-minute assessment.
Abby Fleming, another great player to join us this season. Her work rate is just incredible. You know, there's no 50%, there's no 60%, there's 100% at all times with Abby Fleming, and hopefully it's nothing too serious and we see her back out there, but she's in good hands and she'll be under good care, and what the decisions that need to be made will be made.
Daisy Hilly has come onto the field, and it's not a bad substitution to be able to make. pocket rocket South African is going to be desperate to make an impression in the final few moments of this half.
It's a great game for her to come into as well. She loves a bit of go forward UA, so hopefully she'll thrive and we'll be seeing a lot of line breaks and tackle breaks from her.
Different voices among the Quins set up. We mentioned the Australians, a smattering of South Africans as well, the English and Scots mixing. It's a good setup at the Quins, isn't it? Good different voices.
I love it. Crouch. Yeah, I think, you know, there's so many different people to learn from, and as much as we see each other's opinions when it comes to internationals, like learning from each other on the pitch as a club is just great. Like, I think everyone in the team has got something to teach somebody, which is brilliant.
There's Helle, or just a little bit too previous. Just a bit too keen to get involved in the game.
Number 20 offside, the ball was
out. You can't fault being keen.
Indeed. But Rowland will get a chance to kick to this sideline again. She wasn't accurate previously. Kildan's acrobatics can't quite keep the ball in.
Line's yours. Just wait half a second. We've got to meet in the middle there.
Half-time, and Treader will feed this line-out. It's been a few moments since Lightning had their hands on the ball. They'll want to go through the phases again and try and make a little impression. Rowland will be key to that. Finds Morrell, brought in his Tasker, the try scorer, and Tasker loses the ball. Just as I was about to say, this looks good from Lightning. Helle comes forward with it. Fast knees from the South African. Got her away from the first couple of tackles. Packers pointing and asking people to get in a slightly different position because she wants to find Kildan. This neat little spiral bounces along the floor. Wescombe Evans. Davy, along the back line it goes. Tasker trying to find her way through, just had to stop and check and make sure she had the ball with her. Davy into the hands of Belial. Belial, that's a better carry from her. Morrell, good line again from Wassell. This is how Lightning made an impression a few moments ago with their try. Passages of play adding up. Jade Conkle alongside me might be getting a little bit more nervous the more this game and this passage of play goes on.
You can see me moving. Got back.
Davy, and again, quick hands. Wassell with the couple of inches. Ball behind Rowland. Tidied up, I think, by Matai Toyuga. In they come again. Rowley, her dangerous footwork, trying to find a bit of space. Wescombe Evans, and the ball has been coughed up, and here Harlequins come. Better from them. The exit from Packer is carried back, and therefore more pressure will be applied. Difficult passage of play. I was right, though, wasn't I, Jade? You were just starting to think, I don't want them to have the ball for too much longer.
Yeah. You know, like we've said before, Loughborough, when they are on the attack, they're on the attack. They've got lines running from every direction and they zip passes so well that they create spaces through the deception of the lines they run. And they do it so, so well. We were lucky to get them to cough it up there for Freya to take the ball on the wing, but it just shows how deadly they can be with creating space.
Line out. Treader's arrows have got to be good. Quinn's getting in the way, but not the ball on. Just trying to get themselves, tap the ball back. Ended up in Powell's hands, but definitely had gone forward, which means that it's instead of a line out, it's a scrum now for Lightning to deal with or to act from.
I think we'll be disappointed to still be in this area of the pitch. I feel like when we turned them over in the phases before, we rushed our exit a bit and we're straight back where we started. So again, we want to play with pace, but in the moments that we need to slow down, set up and actually exit properly.
A couple of minutes to go to half time. This could be seen as a relatively crucial passage of the game. The score here from Lightning will definitely make a half-time cup of tea taste a lot sweeter.
Set.
It's a bit chilly. You've just teased me with the thought of a cup of tea.
Davey off the line out. Roland. Matai Toga with the carry. Davey again. Runners with her. Good work from Wassell. Lightning again. Daisy Hibbert-Jones. We've mentioned her precious little. Oh, and it's a penalty which will mean things will be easier for Quinns now. Referee there confirming another minute to go. Our clock is pretty much bang on. Langi Twima will take a large breath, and unfortunately, ball just comes off the side of a boot, and Chloe Rowley comes forward. Doesn't need a second invitation. Roland as well. Trying to find Matai Toga. Toga steps back against the current towards the 22, wrestles her way towards the floor. Lightning are back in the position they were a few moments ago. On the 22-metre line, Davey's going to dig this one out. Rowley behind the screen. Cabella dances towards that 22-metre line. Davey again. Morel. Strong girl, Morel. Just 19 years old, but making an impression in the Allianz PWR. Rowley again. Just had to wait for players to move out the way. Roland, two Quinns tacklers wrap her up. Rowland is allowed to hit the deck. Rowley again. Just keeping the inside tackler honest. Off feet, says the referee, and there's a penalty. It's a free go, and the last time we had one of those, it ended up as a Lightning try. Second advantage coming. Ball flies out. Is the referee going to have a word here? Three in the side, he says, or four crossing. So choice of penalties, about 4 metres apart. Just talk us through, Jade, the mindset here for Quinns, because this is, they'll know what's at stake here. This is tricky, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, you're going to be on the try line, and you're going to want to make sure that they're not scoring before heading in, because that'll give them great confidence at half time. So again, like we said before, it's going to be heads in dark places, because they're going to look to maul this, they're going to look to maul over the try line. So hopefully we can slow them down, and then a bit of pressure in our line speed. We probably lost that a bit there, trying to control the game rather than force an error. So hopefully we get set. But they've started well there.
Malcolm comes down with the ball, and it tussles its way towards the line. Treader is the player placing it back. Morel steps back inside, tries to use her power. Daisy Hibbert-Jones is in close proximity to carry from Emma Wassell. Harlequins celebrate. Another penalty. Come all the way back.
That was a pretty positive starting maul for Loughborough there, so they're probably going to look to go to the corner again and then score off that, because we gave away the penalty at maul time, so they'll be looking to get the same. And you can see Rachel Malcolm's really good in the ref's ear. She'll be saying that's another one in from the side, so he's going to be looking at that for the next one, hoping for another advantage.
Yeah, Rachel Malcolm, the Scotland player, never shy in coming forward in that sort of situation when there's an opportunity in which to shoot an angle with the referee. Shouts of Harlequins echo around the stoop. They know how important this is. Good takedown from Wassell. Again, the rolling maul is formed. Treader is at the back of it. Treader goes left. Oh, this looks ominous! And Catherine Treader is over. And Loughborough Lightning will head into the break with exactly what they like and exactly what they want.
That was really good patience from Loughborough. They got themselves in some dark moments earlier on in that last period of that half, but the fact that they've managed to build, work themselves up off the pitch, played really smartly, went for the maul, and they've come away with points just before the break. It's exactly what they needed to go into the changing room with.
Yeah, talk about Quinns though, underneath those posts, having a word with themselves. What will be being said, do you think, Jade?
You know, they're going to go in, they're going to regather, but they're going to be frustrated with that as well, especially because they managed to stop a couple mauls previously in the game. So, you know, the pressure of it being on your try line is different, but we're going to have to find ways to, you know, not hesitate that split second and actually get in to actually push them back. There, it looked like we just hesitated, we're a bit late to hit and compete. but hopefully, you know, we'll review that. That'll be said. So then when we get into the second half, we'll be a bit more fired on.
Credit to Lightning, mate. Good patience, good belief in their processes. And Roland's kick is just wide. So 7 points the difference as we head into half time. And what a game we have on our hands here at the Twickenham Stoop. A really, really good contest growing. Harlequins certainly with the opening salvo. And Shauna Brown's opening couple of scores seemed as though they were in control. But two late scores from Loughborough Lightning mean at half time it is Harlequins 19, Loughborough Lightning 12. Well, Jade, we'll try and have a look at the trialites and have a look through it. But it's a fascinating narrative that's emerging in this game, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I think we're creating spaces and then we're using that spaces, you know, to our advantage, which is brilliant. Like, we're playing with a bit of flair, excitement and energy. But then Loughborough are bringing that straight back to us, which I think is what is making this such an exciting game. And for it to be 12-19 now, it just shows that it could go either way.
Seems a little while since Shauna Brown was plundering early on.
It does, and hopefully, you know, this is what we need coming out into the second half, is a strong start, again, creating and spotting those gaps.
You must be happy with the way that the Harlequins created their tries, with the skill, the speed, the way that they saw what was emerging coming through. You'll be happy from that point of view, won't you?
Yeah, definitely. It's been a sticky start to the season where we probably haven't moved the ball as much as we'd have liked to, so the fact now that we're challenging ourselves to do that is brilliant, and it has been a very exciting first half to watch, and hopefully it's just going to be just an exciting second half to watch as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
With slightly less tries, ideally, from Loughborough and a bit more from us.
I'll allow you that. I'll allow you. That's fine. But, you know, at this point, as we look at the highlights here, Twima rolling in for the second try. Lightning at one stage, all they were doing were restarting, and it seemed as though Harlequins had this game by the scruff of the neck, didn't it?
Yeah, and I guess that's the exact time that you can't take your foot off the gas. That's when it's so important to, you know, when the kickoff happens, to exit well rather than being camped in your 22. But Loughborough's made that hard and they camped us in our 22 and they've come away with points and brought themselves right back into the game because of it.
Lovely bit of offloading as well. Bryony Cleal, the latest there. Just the presence of mind to find Shauna Brown. Almost no telepathically where Brown was going to be.
Yeah, she worked really, really well there to get her hands free, and she looked to give the offload as she was falling, but then she holds it and gives it at the perfect time.
However, Roland and Lightning, lovely crossfield kick, lovely weight on this, great gather by Tasker as well. And this is where the seeds of doubt started to be sowed.
Yeah, definitely. Again, like, Loughborough have identified the space and used it. They can see that we haven't really come up, and we can't, because if we come up too hard, then they'll run it from the corner with an overlap anyway. So they've used that kick really strategically to actually move the ball wide, which means that we're constantly having to go diagonally back. So they're going to have space either way.
And then just before the break, well constructed, helped a little bit by a penalty count that was growing in Lightning's favour. But this was a little bit of patience and a good score to head into the break with.
Yeah, and Loughborough will be really, really chuffed going in with that. I think they'll go in, they're going to have a lot of positivity in the chats that they're having. They're going to, you know, tidy up on a few things, maybe try and trap the ball a bit more in the collision so we're not getting those offloads away. But, you know, they're going to then look to keep doing what we're doing and making it hard for Loughborough to do that. But for us, we need to really start getting off the line and pressuring their skills rather than giving them the space to play with.
Fascinating game, poised at half-time, down at the Twickenham Stoop. Half-time score, join us for the second half in a little bit. It's Harlequins 19, Loughborough Lightning 12.
Out from the pitch here at the stage, we are ready to the
Right, we're back underway here. Harlequins retake the field. This Allianz PWR matchup between Harlequins and Loughborough Lightning. Tantalisingly poised at the moment. 19 points to 12. Rachel Burford, the captain of Harlequins, there in shot, will have no doubt said some things at half time. What will she have said, do you think, Jade?
I think they'll have been pretty positive at half time. They're going to, you know, really push on what went well, and hopefully they're going to then step up and keep focusing on what went well to then hopefully get more tries in the second half.
Back underway in the boot of Helena Rowland, which was coming into its own in that second half. Finds Ellie Kildan, who returns the kick with interest. From a Loughborough Lightning point of view, Jade Conkle, what will have been said?
Again, I think they will have focused on the positives. They'll say that they're really stretching us defensively, which is what Loughborough do really well. And, you know, they'll have taken a lot of pride in that last couple of minutes of play, so they'll be thriving off that. And again, I think both teams will have focused on the positives because it's a pretty even matchup so far, which has been really good.
Neatly off the top at the line-out. Cabella in the midfield. She has made her impression felt in this first half. Rowland fumbles the ball, then has to go back and get it. And with it, Orkin makes her impression felt. Again, good offloading. Cabella always there, the linchpin seemingly. Very good game at open side at the moment for the England international. I think there's a change there for Lightning. Is it Katie Trevarthen who's on? Did I see 17? Yeah, I can see 17. Flash across my screen, my eye line there.
I just had to squint my eyes on the pitch there. I'm 30 now, this is what happens.
I'm just a little bit older than 30 and I definitely have to squint. Ellie Kildan doesn't squint. She passes the ball neatly out wide to Scott, who tumbles her way towards the halfway line. Connie Powell. Big part of things, as was Bryony Clean in the first half. Well, he's missed and goes over the top of Rachel Burford, and Quinns from Tweema have to bring it forward. Tweema, a little attempted dummy from her. Treader doesn't buy it. Cleal, a little inside ball to Powell, a little half yard made. Good work from Kiara Cooney as well. We haven't mentioned her a huge amount, but if you wear a number six in the back, you go about a little bit rugby with a cloak of invisibility. You do so much work without people seeing it.
You see yourself on the pitch, there's a lot of Bryony Cleo, you know, stepping up and getting the ball, and there's lots of those little tips to Connie Powell. It's a really good partnership that you see in that midfield and that pod.
Packer's going to find Kildan, and Kildan's going to take to the air. Orker and the 50 cap girl is onto that and hits Chloe Rowley with some impact. Spills the ball backwards though, so the players in African violet, as I'm reliably informed that colour is, get the ball and they get the penalty as well. Quick take from Meg Davey. Davey fires the ball off her right hand, inside pass from Herbert Jones. Ball is being juggled and nobody quite knows where it is. Westcott and Evans now on this near side will make or tidy it all up. Davey, little hand in there from Quinns. Referee's not going to be happy with that. Difficult not to agree with him considering it was a one-handed poke.
You can see the intent there in the defensive line, but you know, it's something that you just can't do. You've got to go with two hands, show that it's in the tackle, rather than looking for those intercepts when they're not on.
Rowland will kick to the touchline. Well, if the 5 minutes before half-time was crucial to Quinns, the 5 minutes after half-time is definitely going to be that, isn't it, Jay Conkle?
Yes, it definitely is. And, you know, you can see that Loughborough have come out firing. They'll have taken a lot from that last 5 minutes, and they're putting that into the first 5 minutes as well.
That is the 22-metre line of Harlequins. 7 points in front, but it is finely balanced at the moment, and another good passage of play from the visitors could cause problems. Treader into the midfield, running back is Cabella. Cabella again makes a couple of extra yards, sign of a good player who can do that. Malcolm, the captain for Lightning, also involved. Hibbert Jones has had the ball stolen. And this could be interesting because Quinns are definitely dangerous in broken play. Burford is going to be relieved to be able to come back and take the scrum. Danger isn't fully over though. And it's right in the shadow of the post, this scrum, and the exit will have to be good. Well, very interesting passage of play. This next 10 minutes or so could well dictate the rest of this game, Jade.
Yeah, I think the exit here is going to be really important. We need a solid scrum, a platform, and then look to exit the ball. But whether that's through a kick or running, I'm sure we'll soon find out. You can see that we've split as well, so we've got options both sides. So hopefully we have a stable scrum, so then we can use those options. And you can see Ellie Kildan behind the scrum there, looking to be that pendulum swing in between both attacking options.
Jade Conklin alongside me, still scarred by an early intervention on her commentary, which said that they should do this, and they ended up doing completely the opposite thing. Great to have the Scotland international alongside me. Let me just have a quick personal question. How are you? When will you be back?
It's touch and go at the moment as to when, so we're trying not to put a set date on it. We're just going to see how we progress each block. I'm currently out the boot and off crutches now, so it's a good step in the right direction. And, you know, I've got such great physio care here that I'm just going to keep, you know, doing each block as I can and getting stronger and hopefully be back sooner rather than later. As watching, as much as I'm loving this commentary beside you, Sam, I would much rather be on the pitch.
You're a fibber. Right, I know you'd rather be out on the pitch. I know it. That was actually a question. There's three Harlequins fans who came up to me at half-time and said, Jay Conker, when's she back? When's she back? So I was asking that as much for me as for them as well. Big part of being
If you could ask
here.
My medical staff too, that would be great.
They're famous for evasive answers, aren't they? They'll never quite commit. Certainly they won't... tell the player, because the player is always 2 weeks in front of that, isn't the player? Well, I'll be a bit earlier than that, won't I? I'll be a bit earlier.
Maybe
than
like
that.
3 months in front of that, but if I had my way.
Yeah, you see, that's how difficult it is working as a medical team here. They manage expectations as much as anything. Lightning, however, have a line-out just outside the 22. The opportunity here. Treader's going to play again. Davey. Ball miscommunicated, I think, because Morel, I'm not sure whether she was expecting that. Heller got those knees pumping. She eventually makes the floor. She was ripped, but the referee's going to come back and actually give the knock on from Morel. I'd like to see that passage of play again, because I'm pretty sure Camilla Morel had absolutely no idea that ball was coming to her. But Quinns will have to work their way out again from this scrum.
Yeah, it was great to see a little break there from Aceza. We actually, her nickname's Blommy, which means beautiful flower, which I think is just absolutely fantastic, because you watch her play and she's this physical presence, but she's got a nickname that stands for beautiful flower. It's just so wholesome, and she's a wholesome person and one that's been great to have having the setup.
Yeah, she is living up to her billing. As far as I was concerned, she does like to get her hands on the ball. She does like to get the knees going.
I've been on the reverse end of those knees, and I can assure you they're not the most pleasant to run into.
Quinns, Packer and Ellie Kildan will combine. Well, a little nudge over the top, a little disguise on that one. Although Matai Toga is going to come forward with the ball. Tackle looked a little high, referee doesn't agree with me. Inside ball, Hibbert Jones, nice bit of interplay there. Brings in Westcombe. Evans off her left wing. Lightning again. Work of Wassell, who's been a many mentioned name so far for Lightning. Out the back it goes. Totoga. Haven't breached the 22 metre line yet. Rowland will look to do things on her own. She tumbles towards that line. Davey spins the ball out. Hibbert Jones. Ball behind. Morel gathers a little bit of space from Malcolm. She has to come back in field. Inching their way forward. Hibbert Jones just taking the inside pass again. It was a feature of the game in the first half, those inside tap balls. Davey getting another inside ball. Morel drops it again. Morales handling, just letting the side down at the moment. I'm sure they'll get around it. It can happen to the best of us, but at the moment, Lightning with the ball, but not the incision.
No, and you can see that again, they're really stressing our defence. You can see that on one side of the ruck, we've got players coming up. On the other side, it's a bit more lateral. And again, they're really getting good go forward of those inside balls, just because you can see that we're on our heels a bit. So we need to make sure that we're communicating with our left and right and actually getting off the line. Because again, if they're making these errors in attack, we need to make sure that we're forcing them 5 metres behind where they're currently happening.
Abby Dwigid is going to make way. And Sally Williams, who is a late addition to the 23, comes in wearing 19 on her back. A Brucey bonus. Not in the squad this morning, and now onto the field for the second half, Sally Williams.
Just goes to show you've got to always be ready as a travelling reserve. You just never know when the call-up might happen.
Indeed.
Crouch. Bind.
Quinn still in there, 22. Set. Still trying to find a way out of this particular predicament. Packer and Brown make an absolute horlicks of that. Lightning seize on the ball. It is Lightning's. And in they come, and all offside. And free go, says the referee. He hasn't blown his whistle yet, and I think it's going to be a yellow card. As soon as she caught that ball, almost by instinct, she knew she was in trouble. I'm going to have a little chat with the referee. But yeah, it's so difficult, you know. Connie Powell running back finds herself in the position, but you're going to be hypercritical. It's a silly mistake.
It is a silly mistake, especially from, you know, one of Connie's caliber. She knows better than that, and she's going to be kicking herself for that. But she's going to come back on in 10 minutes and hopefully, you know, right the wrongs that just happened. But it just goes to show that we need to take those moments that we've got. And in the last scrum, I think we wheeled slightly to the left, and we need to use that wheel to our advantage by taking away that blindside flanker and creating the space on the blindside. There, I think we panicked and tried to get the ball behind us rather than using the wheel to our advantage.
The yellow card is going to create further problems on the bench, because I think they've opted for the scrum, which means that you're going to have to have a bit of a shift around. Maybe Dobson will come on and another player will have to leave the field.
It's always, you know, as a back row, it usually tends to be a back row that comes off. So you know that if there's a card in the front row, a back row is going to usually have to come off for a front row to go on. However, in my front row days, usually it was just me that went up, so it was just as bad.
20. Going off replacement for the yellow card. It's Zeza Hele who's going to make way. So the substitute is going to have to take a little 10-minute break alongside the yellow carded Connie Powell.
You can see Hannah Sims getting ready to come on. So whether Sylvia Tirani moves to the hook. Hannah Sims has been playing exceptionally well this season. Since she's been on the pitch, anytime she's on the pitch, she makes such a big impact. So I'm not surprised that they've brought her on for the duration of the card.
Yeah, the former Wasps and Bristol front rower, and it is Tirani who slips into the middle.
It's almost as if I know the players. Just knew what was going to happen.
Honestly, yeah. You've got a future in this game, you know that. However, problem still exists for Harlequins, and that is a defence of a scrum. 5 metres out, Lightning with a player advantage, and put into the scrum. Davey does just that. Lightning apply pressure. Round it goes, the referee's arm comes out. This is the house's money that Lightning will play with. Roland along the back line. There's a bit of space out here, and it is Westcombe Evans. There is their third score, and Bo Westcombe-Evans already has 3 to her name this season. She is the Lightning's biggest threat, and she gets on the scorecard.
Again, we're looking at another try in the wide channel. I'd love to see that back to see why we were such a big number down on the wide channel there. You could see Freya Ocken in the second player before that. So where did it come from that there was the mismatch in numbers?
It did seem relatively straightforward that came. There's the mismatch. Is it people, numbers?
Well, as you can see, Lucy Packer tries to target the actual nine from the scrum, but because it's wheeled so much, it would be really difficult for them to pick open, so maybe we needed somebody from the blind side on that to fold around a bit quicker to give us those numbers to get up and pressure it.
Helena Rowland's kick from way out on the left-hand touchline is unfortunately dragged to the left. Unfortunately for Lightning's point of view, it is a two-point game. 19 points to 17. And it is intriguing. It really is, because Harlequins have got to get their themselves together, should we say. They've got to have a really... on the hoof, they've got to work this through and find it. They were in such ascendancy in that first half. It was almost comical. Daisy Hibbert-Jones is going to run after this. The ball is going to be shepherded by the Harlequins players, and it goes from bad to worse. It happens so often in a game of rugby, doesn't it? You have a bad period, and then inexplicably, Ellie Kildane has just spooned that. 99 times out of 100, she's never going to do that. But it always happens in that sort of situation.
It does, and you do see that a negative, then a negative, then a negative, and unfortunately we need to somehow get past that. I like the idea of going short, because it means that we're getting the ball back, but ultimately when we've just come from a try down, maybe the right time is to park them in their 22, force an error so then we're in their 22, or at least get the ball back from a return on the 10 metre line.
Fascinated to hear from you, Jade. I know it's easier from up here what the next step is for Quinns, how they right this ship and rebalance the process. Let's see how this unfolds. The kick is going to come in from Davey. Ball into the 22, it bounces once. Ellie Kildane is going to take to her feet. She's going to find herself through and her way through an inexplicably small hole, but then the offload comes and it bounces into the hands of Lightning. But all of a sudden, she may have gifted a chance here. Forward Lightning come, Malcolm, Mate Toga bouncing players out of the way. Mate Toga up to the line. All of a sudden, Lightning in the mood. Towards the line they go. The referee looks. The referee gives it. What a 5 minutes this is for Lightning. Two tries in quick succession, and the game and the complexion has changed.
Yeah, it definitely has, and hats off Loughborough there. They've come out absolutely firing and it's showing. We did that in the first half, so it does just show that teams can bounce back, and I've still got all the faith in Harlequins to, you know, right the wrongs there, but massive, massive hats off Loughborough there. They've really identified the space. You can see again, that is another one in the corner. A bit surprised it didn't happen a phase or two sooner. I think it definitely could have, just a switch of the hips and then out to the 11. But, you know, they were patient there. They played quick and then straight through.
Good line from Sally Williams this to hit power, pace. Two players in, you know, there and ready to make the tackle, but they couldn't do anything about it because of the speed.
Yeah, when you've got somebody running at you, that kind of line where you're cutting back in and the speed and the change of pace from when you hit the ball, it's really hard to get off the line and actually march it back. You can kind of soak up that tackle, but ultimately she's over the try line by that point anyway.
Roland, slightly closer with this kick still. It's tucked to the left. Never mind, it is 10 points from two tries for Loughborough Lightning. A little word about Ellie Kildane. I could see what she was trying to do, find a way out of problems, but then the last piece of the jigsaw was one where she chucked the ball away and caused the problems.
Yeah, Christine Belisle really was aware that the offload was coming and actually was in the way for that, and again, just really good awareness of where the ball is and what we're trying to do, which is move the ball, and they're shutting down the options to do that.
Babala Latcher has come onto the field. Bryony Cleal has left. Latcher brings a huge amount of international experience, but feels a big hole to fill. Kildane trying to scamper through half a gap. Packer, this is where I feel Quinns just need to grab a hold of this game, hold on to the ball. Still offloading. Good. Neatly played down this right-hand side. 50-cap woman, Freya Alken, makes her way towards the 22. Can't panic, though, as Jade Conkle was saying. There's a lot to play in this game. It can switch. It switched in the first half. It can definitely switch Harlequin's way, but they need to hold on to the ball. Don't need to chase it at the moment. Packer comes back this way. Ball is spilt but goes backwards. Referee agrees. Packer again. Rani misses her, and then on the deck, Packer again. Scott changes her direction, looks for a little gap, brought down well by Morell. Holding on, and the Loughborough Lightning crowd that has travelled down here is just getting a little bit more vocal. And my guess is that Jay Conkle alongside me is getting a little bit more nervous.
Yeah, I'm really having to like clench every so often, but yeah, you could see just the lack of options in attack there. We didn't really have anything set, which meant we had to go back down the blind, whereas normally, you know, we want to have options from both forwards and backs, especially if we're playing from an edge. But there, I'd say we had a pod, but then nothing outside of that for both backs and forwards, which, you know, ultimately means that we're running into a passive collision.
There are some people in the world who think momentum in sport is not a thing, it's almost made up, but my theories would suggest that at the moment Loughborough Lightning have all the momentum in this game. Morell, just the sort of player you don't want to give half a gap to. Quins have got to stay clever here. Davey, that's a neat little chip through, and it's going to cause problems. Kildan, the tap on. Referee says play. That could work. Half does. Good carry. What can I think it was with that? Latcher. Again, another good carry. Tarani joins in. Lightning themselves have got to be careful that they don't get too carried away. Shauna Brown, two tries from her in the first half. Seems an age away. Kildan is stood on the 22-metre line, looking to kick the ball downfield. Her right boot does just that. It's going to bounce awkwardly. Lightning players almost collide, but eventually Rowland grabs hold of it. Good chase from Wilcock. And that has been ripped, and Quinn suddenly have the ball. Out wide it goes. Latcher, big bend from her. Latcher going through Loughborough Lightning players at a rate of knots.
Oh, Beebe's on the run, and you know that's never going to be good for a defensive line. Great, great amount of metres made. But actually in the corner, I love it when you see a back trying to make a maul out of a tackle.
Kildan, bit of space, outside, Ocken, Ocken into the 22, Ben from Ocken, Ocken's going to score! Oh no, referee has seen a knock on. We were blind to it from our angle. Jade Conkle was about to do a lap of her own, but they're going to come back. Oh, this game is delivering drama, it really is. Let's have another look at this. I don't know whether we'll see it from this angle, but it was well made, wasn't it, on this outside?
Lovely identification of space, and again, you see Freya really turn on the gas on the wing. And we're watching carefully to see what happens.
I think credit has to go here. I'm not sure whether or not actually a hand comes over from, is it Westcombe Evans on this? Yeah, it is. I'm not sure whether she dislodges the ball. If she has, that's a superb defensive tackle.
Absolutely brilliant. And again, sometimes it is about the smart play of going for ball, forcing the error, because you know you're not going to get the player into touch. So how else can you work out the defence?
Kildan comes forward with it. Scott, the ball bouncing around. Tarani. That cheesecake I mentioned earlier seems to have be working wonders at the moment. Bouncing around the field. Harlequins just starting to grab this game once again. That player, that shirt, definitely making a little bit of difference. Up to the 22 they go. Packer is waiting for the ball to present itself. She eventually gets her hands on it. Carry from Leaney. Crucial just to reposition players. Burford, a little step from her. Lovely hands from Tweema. Kildan out to the left-hand side. Here goes Wilcock. Wilcock for that corner. Stopped just short. On a penalty. Once again, Lightning are able to douse the fire.
again, I think we need to take care of our ball. We have only got 14 players on the pitch, and that's something we need to remember. So in those collisions, we need to make sure we're getting there quick and we're clearing with two. But right now, we're a bit too slow to the breakdown, whereas then we're playing with a bit slower ball, giving us less options, and then ultimately slower to the breakdown to be turned over.
That's an excellent point. Jade Conkle alongside me, in a way, in their fervour to make themselves back into this game. You've got to play the numbers, you've got to play the sensible stuff as well. Plenty of time left in this, and that yellow card has been spent. So therefore, Powell comes back. So does Azeza Haley, and actually it's Turani who's going to come off, and she's going to smile her way all the way in.
I think she's been exceptional today. She's created so many opportunities for other people to break the line. The amount that she changes her body position to actually create those gaps has been brilliant, and she's given us a lot of good go forward.
Don't change, five, don't change.
Loughborough come down with the ball and operate a neat rolling position. Went inside their own half, but still very effective. Davies going to get an opportunity to feed her back line. Big pass off the right hands is going to create a little bit of space on this left side. Westcombe Evans, just the kick inside, ricochets. Referee says leave it alone. Latcher does well to position herself and free the ball up. Shauna Brown's rather large shoulders coming into their own, knocking players down to the floor. Done. Another awkward spiral for Westcombe Evans to deal with. She does just that though. Westcombe Evans to the halfway line. The sound and the electricity within this stadium just being ratcheted up at the moment. The exclamations and body language is getting a little bit more physical. Kabaya, as she has done all game, brilliant. Hibbert Jones into the 22. Quinns have got to be clever here. The ball is loose. Kildun doesn't know where it is. And it was lost forward. And this game is on a knife edge, isn't it?
That's a lovely run from Hibbert Jones there. And you can see the like effect it has when two players go high to tackle her. She just keeps her legs pumping. So she's ultimately running against two people. But we just need to chop her legs. We need to put her on the floor well before she's got up to that mark. We're lucky there that, yes, the ball has been knocked on. But ultimately, we need to do better in our collision to actually not let her get that far in the first place.
Breathers being taken.
Is that not a strip, rather?
A little bit of running repairs on Lochner for few checks from the players to the referee about exactly what happened at the last breakdown, but I think mostly is gathering oxygen. It is a furious game, this. Brilliant example of Premiership Women's Rugby.
It's great to see it so end-to-end. I'm really having to watch my Scottish vocab.
Well, we can't bleep you, but we can understand if it does get a bit industrial, so we say.
I'll try my best.
Industrial is definitely what Harlequins have to do here in their own 22. They have to work hard against this Lightning side who have their energy up, shall we say. Kildun. Her kick is going to find Chloe Rolley, who just thinks about where she's going before she sets off. Rolley bounces away from the first player. Lochner wraps her up, says you ain't going anywhere. Lochner's opposite number, Emma Wassell, carries again. Rowland playing at the line, the ball over the top. Matatoga. Carry from the substitute Chavarvan. Again, good running from the ladies in violets. High tackle and a nod, an appreciative nod from the lady alongside me, Jade Conkle, who sees it as much as an opportunity in which to just release some of this pressure that was being applied.
Yeah, definitely. I think that was really well read in defence. You could see the chop tackle being made, meaning that you've got scope to then get over. Sometimes people get over, but actually there's still a player trapped and it's not the right time, but that was well read. Chop down to ground, straight over, and then we get the ball back and actually relieve that pressure.
Yeah, heading towards the last 15 minutes of this game. Or into, should I say. It's moved at the clock there for me. However, this is the truth. It is a fascinating contest. It really is. Next score sounds obvious, sounds cliche, but the next score, whatever it is, going to be crucial. Quinns come down with it. Neat ball into the midfield. Tweema gets a chance to find Shauna Brown. The tackles go low on her. Second player comes in, tries to rip it. Packer behind the screen. Scott has runners. One of them is Ellie Kildun. Here on this right-hand side is Caitlin Leaney. Open pasture for her. Second row partner of Lochner. Joining up. Carry from Latcher. Towards that line. Benner from Quinns. More speed, more options. Makes the game of rugby easier if you have both. Scott again, ball out wide. Wilcock, half through the gap, Wilcock towards that line. Good run from the left winger. Packer comes in. Oh, it's a miss again. Knock on, offside, says the referee. This will be fodder for the Quinns players.
Never onside behind the back foot.
Never onside, says the referee.
Such an important passage of play for Harlequins there. Again, you can see a lot of what happened in the first half. We're getting that quick ball, the good go forward. We as a team, we know how important a bonus point win is for this game, and we need this next try in order to seal the four tries.
Indeed we do. Four tries would be half of the job done, dare I suggest.
In the players for Harlequins, leave the field. A
couple more substitutions. Beth Wilcock and Lucy Packer are going to come off. Flo Robinson and Izzy Mayhew is also going to come on as well. A couple of very experienced cammy operators making their way to the field. I can't say I'm surprised with the game so poised.
I think it's great to use the bench, you know, get some fresh legs on there. But hats off to Lucy Packer and Beth Wilcox, both put in a shift today. Really big shout out to Beth Wilcox there. I think she created a lot of opportunity on the wing and defended a lot of really tricky passages of defence.
Rolling maul is formed.
That's Quinns to floor there.
Oh, ball has been dropped. Oh, the frustration. I can see it alongside me. Jade Conkle immediately hands to the head. Oh dear, it is tense, it really is.
Miscommunication there between when you take the ball at the back of the maul. I think it was done a bit early. We were getting go forward, we hadn't really been told to use it with a second warning yet. Yes, Loughborough were coming over the top and getting closer, but we didn't have to rush it as much as we did there.
Substitution for Loughborough. Westcombe Evans is going to come off. Well, certainly that's the indication from the referee. And Wales international Karis Williams Morris is going to take the field. There she is.
Again, really good day for Westcombe Evans. I think she's had a really good shift on the wing. Lots of space and she's used it well. I thought she had a great game so far.
It's Loughborough's put into this scrum, but set. Pressure can be applied. Quinns can still do damage without the ball here. Away Loughborough come. Morrell is going to try and grab a couple of extra yards to make the exit a bit easier. Roland is back and the referee says
crossing,
protecting the runner. Oh, sorry, should I say protecting the kicker was the runner. And now, all of a sudden, there's an opportunity here for Harlequins.
You know, in my head, I'm like, yeah, we go for the posts, we take time, but I don't think we're doing that.
Connie Powell has other ideas. Latcher two, three players trying to bring her down. The ball is ricocheting off the foot, not the hand. Referee says play on. Forward they come again. Ball is going to be positioned. Robinson is tiptoeing in and then out and allowing Shauna Brown to get her hands on it. Brown testing the gate.
Arrive up, Quinns, please, arrive up.
We've changed direction there in the pick and goals. Hopefully looking for those little gaps.
Penalty coming. Advantage here, Quinns, have a go. Players fan round in the back line. You can't possibly see that, but there's a bit of movement because of the free go. Out left, it tails wide for the line. Did they get it down? No, they didn't. I'm going to go all the way back. The referee's going to bring it back for the penalty.
There's a big gap for Emily Scott there. I'm surprised she gave that ball just there.
Powell for the line. Short plays the ball back. South Africans are loitering. Hele. Hele! Oh, there she is.
I was about to say the body height there was a bit high. That's when you get hit back. But she did it really well there to rotate and actually spin out of the collision and find that space.
That's easy, Hele. Well, you gave her her nickname a bit of a name check a little bit earlier. That's flowering beautifully, isn't it?
Absolutely beautiful. Again, really, really pleased that she got that there. And we've managed to score a lot closer to the post, so hopefully we can get this conversion and start building the scoreboard back up. Take a breath in the positive play that has just come, but it does not count until we are back in their half.
Langi Tuima will have a kick to just ease things. 2 points the advantage at the moment. Seems relatively straightforward for a player of Tuima's caliber.
Never in doubt.
There we go. So, 4 points the difference. Both teams with 4 tries. And I'm going to test a bit of a rugby idiom. You haven't scored until you've gathered the restart.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie, I feel a bit sick.
Here we go. Quinns have got to make sure here. It's a decent kick from Rowland. Underneath it is the safe Lochner. Danielle Lochner playing a staunch game this afternoon for Quinns.
That was a lovely take, because off when you've been on the back foot to then score, actually that kind of high ball.
Not down. I stopped Jade Conkle in her tracks as once again the ball is bouncing around and offside, because the knock-on happened, and unfortunately the try scorer Hele reacted, as he's so it is so difficult to do in the heat of the battle to gather your thoughts and realise that the person behind you has just knocked the ball on, but she did, and it's a penalty, which means there are choices to be made here. Do we go to the corner? We do. We don't look at the posts. I don't know.
I think that's sensible from Loughborough, because they did get good go forward with their mauls in just before half time.
They did.
So I do think it's a sensible option, but hopefully, again, because we've just come off of a try, that we're really going to hit this straight up without hesitating and actually push them back or stop them dead.
What an interesting 5 minutes we have in store. If you're just joining us, it's probably the best 5 minutes you could have joined us for. Brilliantly poised this game. Loughborough Lightning have fought their way back in once. Can they do it again? Harlequin's fourth try has given them the lead. Behind the screen they come. Crossfield kick is hanging up in the London air. It's brilliantly taken by Tasker once again. She did it so well in the first half. Lightning are going to have to rebuild. Oh, knock on. No advantage, says the referee, though.
So again, you could see another penalty come from the mall there. It looks like initially we've gone to kind of hesitated around the sack, or you just go in and blitz, but then ultimately the sack's come too late once they've got go forward, giving away an easy penalty.
I think the question is going to be the same one. Loughborough Lightning are going to ask exactly the same question, but this time, crucially, they're going to be about 4 yards closer to that line. nervous times for any Quins players, any Quins fans, as Lightning once again push towards that line. Up goes the line out. Well taken. Looked as though it was brought down.
Beautiful initial sack there. That's exactly with everyone being on the same page.
Forward they roll. Lightning in the mood. Over the line they go. It's given. Try scored. There's still time in this game, but what a score. Bottom of that pile. I'm not 100% sure who comes out with it.
As much as Helena's holding the ball, I'd like to think it wasn't her at the bottom of that mall.
It wasn't her. It wasn't Eleanor Rowland. Was it Treader? We'll have a look here. It might be difficult to see. 3.5 minutes left in this game. It is Treader at the back there. It usually is this hooker position that ends up coming with the ball. I think she's got it here. I think it might be Treader. The USA International is going to be credited with this one.
You can see when they catch that line out that Emma Wassell actually catches it on her outside shoulder. So they were lucky there to get a straight throw, but ultimately they got sacked straight away, but regrouped and gathered and actually had really good position to keep that maul going. So that's, you know, it's actually really technical to do in a maul. To see them actually manage to regroup after being sacked was brilliant. So a well-worked try from the maul.
Rowland's kick. She had two goes at it previously from that side of the pitch and missed both of them. But that one, much to the appreciation of Emily Scarrett, has gone directly through the post, and it is a 3-point game.
Yeah, I think that conversion is going to be so, so important. It just opens up that scoreboard that little bit more, and it does make decision making for Harlequins all that more important.
Kildan with another short line out. It doesn't go 10. Kildan bends at the waist in as much exasperation and frustration as anything else. Time out of the game this scrum will take, if nothing else.
Again, that kick was a bit further on than the last time. It didn't go 10, but ultimately it's another easy, easy ball to give away.
I reckon we've got about 2 minutes to play in this game.
Oh, I didn't actually realise the time. Thanks for that.
I like to keep people informed. Oh, wow. There are 1,000 people in this ground at the moment. They are all on the edge of their seats. Lightning. All they need is the ball in their hands and maybe a chance to create a bit of territory. Push Quins back as far as possible. But any kick would still give Quins the ball back. Robinson is working hard to try and get it out. Is that time? Oh, it is time!
Ref, I'd like to say there's still a minute on the TV clock.
Well, the ref obviously had indicated that was the case. And Lightning, with a famous victory at the Stoop, managed it, picked the pocket, created the upset, call it what you like, but Loughborough Lightning have come away with the points. No doubt a disappointed Jay Conkle. Can you try and put that into words?
I think heartbreaking is the current word that I've currently got. It'll be heartbreaking for the players on the pitch, heartbreaking for the players not on the pitch, and heartbreaking for the fans. I think today was such an important game, and you know, we've managed to come away with the four tries and a losing bonus point, but we were targeting a bonus point win. Hats off to Loughborough. I think the way they came out in that second half, I think from scoring in the last play of the first half to the second half, they came out absolutely firing, and ultimately they've come out on top because of that.
The Quins were a little bit like Jekyll and Hyde that first half. There was so much ascendancy, so much power, and then it seemed to disappear. I mean, it's kind of a microcosm of the season. So good in places, and then oddly sort of it disappears at times.
Yeah, and I think that's the most frustrating thing, is it's so evident that we are an exciting team to play, but it needs to be more consistent. And right now we're lacking that consistency in performances. Again, like you say, we'll either start well or we'll finish well, but what about those bits in between? How do we step up? Because at the moment, when something negative happens, we let that go on for that little bit too long until we get back into control, whereas that needs to be immediate. Once never happens, you park it onto the next job and it's a clean slate. But right now, I think we're letting too many negatives influence the outcome.
Extraordinary game. We're going to have a look at the highlights in a moment. An extraordinary game at the Stoop. Full-time score, Harlequins 26, Loughborough Lightning 29. Well, just try and put yourself into the Lightning camp. It will be jubilant. It will be so excited to have pulled that off. And I mean that in a sense that they were behind in so many facets of that game. To take the lead at that crucial moment is going to be massive for their season.
Yeah, massively. And I think they can take so much pride in the way they attacked in that second half, especially. Again, just the identification of space. It's just smart play. They were looking at the options. They were listening to the ref. They were using their advantages to their advantage. Again, they knew that we were giving away penalties around the mall, so they targeted the corner rather than points, which ultimately created that bigger gap.
Let's have a little look at the highlights, and there were a fair few. I'm going to take you back to this passage of play and the way that Lightning exploited a bit of space out here on the left-hand side. Talk us through this.
Again, yeah, you can see that the scrum is wheeled, but actually we've got three people on the blind side, but I can only see Chloe Rowley in the camera, which I imagine another person far side. So I reckon we needed to bring another player over to be able to marry up to actually get the line speed up, but we've given them too much space on the edge, and then they've capitalised on that.
And this was the start. I mean, we talked about it at half-time, the way that Lightning had struck just before half-time, gone into the half with their tails up, and this was the crucial play to put themselves back in. Yes, they lost the lead again, but this kind of gave them the belief.
Yeah, and I think we made it too easy for them. Like, they've just done basic catch pass. They've done it very, very well, but we've allowed them the space to do that.
Yeah, and once again, Lightning coming up with the goods here as well. And it was a strange game in a way, but a wonderful exhibition of what women's rugby is now turning into, a real humdinger of a clash.
Absolutely, and I think there's so many great players, and you've got so many great players of all different nationalities as well here playing in England in the Premiership, and I just think it's fantastic to see, because you're seeing so much different types of rugby as well. You're seeing, you know, the attacking flair, you're seeing the set piece dominance, you're seeing defensively like massive hits and actually just smart play. I think you get such an array of abilities and what different people bring, and I just think it makes for exciting rugby, and that's from all the teams in the Premiership, not just the two that we've seen today.
Let's focus a little bit on Quins, if you don't mind, if it's not too painful. Where does this leave them? I mean, we saw that this was a moment which potentially saw it swing back their way, and you thought, oh, well, maybe they've done enough, but it wasn't to be today.
It wasn't, and I think we're going to have to go back and reflect hard as well, and I think we need to be a little bit more, I guess not hard, but honest. Like, where did we let ourselves down? I think look at the decision making around different areas where we tapped and go, didn't go for the corner, or maybe where, you know, we gave away those penalties that didn't need to be done, or, you know, the kickoffs, for example. Even on the kickoffs, it's come from giving them the ball back, and I think we need to look at those areas and do better, because when games come down to these margins, you need to capitalise on those mistakes, and that's what Loughborough did against us.
Yeah, painful afternoon, but you learn so much from losses. I mean, it sounds glib, it sounds dull, but in a way, in the position that Harlequins are, there will be a lot of learning going on at the moment, a lot of understanding of where they need to be. It's not as though they don't know how to do it, it's about doing it more consistently.
Yeah, it's about piecing it together, because actually everyone that we've got at the club are exceptional players, and that's not just the people that are on the pitch, it's all the people that help prepare the squad that play on the Saturday, and that comes to a massive amount of players. I couldn't even tell you the number. It's well in the 40s. You know, everybody's got a part to play, and we do that so well, but we just need to somehow turn that into victories, and that's what we're struggling with a bit at the moment. But again, that's the beauty of sport. It goes up and down and round and about, but it's how we learn. And you know, a great achievement for Freya Auchin, being such a young player. I think she's something like 23, getting her 50th cap today. Absolutely unreal. So you know, you've got to look at those positive moments as well, and actually the building we are doing in this club.
Jade Conkle, thank you so much for being alongside me. It's been absolutely brilliant. I hope you've enjoyed it, kind of.
For the most part. You were a pleasure.
Thank you. A fantastic afternoon of Allianz Premiership Women's Rugby. A full-time score here from the Stoop. Harlequins Women 26, Loughborough Lightning 29. Until next time, a very safe journey to wherever you're going, and join us again on PWR.